Hello, Matthias here. I thought I would do an episode about one of my favorite artists in any category, Elmore James. I discovered him when I was in my mid-teens. I first bought this one actually, Fleetwood Mac, the cheap collection of songs. And they did a few covers of Elmore James, like Shake Your Money Maker and Dust My Broom, Got to Move. And I really fell in love with Jeremy Spencer's slide guitar. But after a while, I understood that it wasn't Fleetwood Mac originals, but it was a blues guy named Elmore James who did the original. So I started looking for Elmore James, and I bought any CD, any LP, cassette, all kind of comps. This was in the late 80s, so I bought anything I could see. And I was really proud in my, you know, at home in my boy room. I made lists of how many songs I had with Elmore. I think it was about 45 songs or something, and I was really proud of it. But anyway, later on, I started collecting 45s, and I've done so for many years now, and I have bought a lot of Elmore James. I still love him. I will always love his music. I thought I would tell you one story about his first recording session that he did for the Bizzare brothers, who owned the Modern, Flare and RPM labels. Elmore James was in contract with Lillian McMurray, and they had released Dust My Broom, his first record, on trumpet in 1951. I don't have the, it was only released on 78 RPM, and I just don't have it yet. I don't know why, but I do have the first press on 45, which is on the Ace label. This was released in, it's a reissue. It was released in 1955. Actually, probably more rare than the 78. But I will have the 78 someday. Anyway, they had released it and it was a hit. And the Bizzare brothers heard it, of course, and they got interested, and they thought that, hell, we need to snag him before someone else does. So, Joe Bizzare and Ike Turner, who worked as a talent scout for the brothers, took their Cadillac and drove to Mississippi to try and locate Elmore James. They went to different cities, but ended up in Canton. And they finally found him at a radio repair shop that where he was working. Elmore was good on electronics, and he's known for that, and he worked on his guitars and amps, customized them and so on. And probably that's one reason why he got the sound he did. They went there and they asked him if he was interested in recording with them. They had a portable tape recorder with them. He said he agreed. Elmore probably thought that this is a chance for me to maybe get out of Mississippi and hit it big. And they went to a nightclub, Club Bizzare. This was in late January 1952. And they recorded over a couple of hours until morning. Ike Turner was on piano. The other musicians are unknown. I think it's not many musicians. It's a small combo only. And they recorded a few songs. It was among them among the songs, it was this one, Please Find My Baby. And it was Hand in Hand. And Hand in Hand is really it's a huge favorite. It's so good. The thing is, the recording is really rough. And it's probably the closest you can come to on how Elmore James sounded live on stage. They recorded a few more songs. Rock My Baby Right is one also that later was released on 45. Bizzare and Turner went back to California and they planned to release a single. Lillian McMurray found out about the record session just a couple of days after, and she became furious and really disappointed in Elmore going behind her back. And she filed a lawsuit against the Bizzare brothers. So it was stopped just right before it was sent to pressing plants. So they couldn't release it. But anyway, Elmore's and Lillian's relationship was quite bad after this, and the contract went out, and I think the Bizzare brothers actually signed Elmore just one day after the contract with Lillian went out. So they released a couple of other 45s by him before these songs from the session at Club Bizzare got released. But finally they were released. Please Find My Baby was released in December 1953, and Hand in Hand was released in March of 1954. Okay, I think we can listen to a Hand in Hand so you can hear how it sounded. Really, really nice, and Elmore's guitar sounds absolutely brilliant. It's as rough as it can sound, and it's really cool that it is from 1952, considering the sound. Thank you. Okay, that was Elmore, Hand in Hand. Absolutely brilliant. I showed you a bit from the book by Steve Franz, The Amazing Secret History of Elmore James. Really a good read. Not much is known about Elmore James, but Steve Franz, he did a really great job with this book. So it's the only thing you need, actually, if you want to know stuff about Elmore James, because you can't find anything similar anyway. Absolutely brilliant book. Hope you enjoyed this little history, and see you next time.